The final step is to do a quick data check to make sure we didn't miss anything. Again, there are many ways you could do a data check. I'm using procfreak to do mine. Specifically, in my table statement, I'm asking SAS to give me a contingency table with possible responses for HADPAP2 in the rows by possible responses for LASTPAP2 in the columns. I'm also asking for a separate one-way frequency table for my new variable PAP5. I want to compare the values in PAP5 with the values in HADPAP2 and LASTPAP2. Finally, to keep the table cleaner, I've added the no%, no row, and no call options. These suppress the output of the overall percent, row percent, and column percent respectively. I've also added the missing option, which tells SAS to display missing values in our contingency table in the same way it displays any other category. For this particular data check, the missing option is necessary. And this is the report we get when we run procfreak. It tells us that 16,222 participants said that they have ever had a PAP test, and also said that they've had one in the past 5 years, which is the same number we got in our new variable. So far, so good. Next, we can see that 4,543 participants said that they have had a PAP test, but they had it 5 or more years ago. We can also see that 1,369 participants said they have never had a PAP test, and therefore have also not had a PAP test in the past 5 years. 1,369 plus 4,543 equals 5,912, which is the answer we got. Finally, let's take a look at who we haven't classified as a yes or a no in our new variable. Well, we can ignore all the zeros. There are no participants there. We can also ignore the marginal totals. These participants didn't answer either question, so we have no information regarding their PAP test history. These four participants said that they've had a PAP test, but they didn't tell us how long ago they had it. The same is true for these 502 participants. Unfortunately, we don't know if their PAP test was 10 days ago or 10 years ago. Therefore, the only value we can give them for PAP5 is missing. Finally, these 162 participants didn't tell us whether they've ever had a PAP test or not. We certainly can't say if they've had one in the last 5 years or not. Therefore, the only value we can give them for PAP5 is missing. And again, these numbers all add up to exactly the answer we got. We can now feel confident that we have appropriately accounted for the skip pattern. Now we can run a simple one-way frequency table to answer our research question. What proportion of women that participated in the 2015 BRFSS have had a PAP test in the past 5 years? The answer is 73% of women who participated in the 2015 BRFSS had a PAP test in the past 5 years. Before we wrap up, let's quickly recap what we learned in this video. Your first task is just to identify the skip patterns. Then you must decide if you need to do anything to account for the skip pattern. I suggested you do this by thinking about your research question and the other information available to you in the context of the entire dataset. Once you've decided that you need to account for the skip pattern, you can do so using the conditional processing techniques you already know. Finally, it's always a good idea to do data checks. I've been working with data for many years, and I still catch myself making mistakes all the time during my data checks. So please don't forget to do them. And with that, we've concluded our discussion of skip patterns.